We want to write the system of equations as an augmented matrix and then solve the system by writing the matrix in row echelon form. So the first thing we should recognize is that we have a system of two linear equations with two unknowns. So we'll have a 2x3 augmented matrix. We'll use the first equation to form the first row in the matrix and the second equation to form the second row. So looking at the first equation, the first row would be 2, negative 1, 4. The second row would be 4, negative 2, 5. Notice how the coefficients of x gave us the first column, the coefficients of y gave us the second column, and the constants gave us the third column. Also notice the linear equations had to be in standard form in order to write the augmented matrix. Now let's go ahead and review what it means for a matrix to be in row echelon form. The first non-zero element in each row, called the leading entry, is 1. Second, each leading entry, or 1, is in a column to the right of the leading entry, or 1, in the previous row. And 3, rows with all zero elements, if any, are below rows having a non-zero element. So we have several examples here below. One way to approach this would be to focus on the main diagonal, which is highlighted here in yellow. Notice in most cases the main diagonal will consist of 1s, but it is also possible to have a 0 in the main diagonal. If we do have a 0 in the main diagonal, it's an indication that we have either no solution or infinite solutions. But notice how every element below the main diagonal, highlighted here in blue, is 0. This is important to notice because this will give us a strategy for writing a matrix in row echelon form. The way we transform a matrix into row echelon form is to perform a process called Gaussian elimination, which means any two rows can be interchanged, the elements of any row can be multiplied by a non-zero real number, and finally any row can be changed by adding or subtracting the corresponding elements with another row. So going back to our example, again, because we have a 2x3 augmented matrix, our first step is to focus on obtaining a 0 here in row 2, column 1. So what we're going to end up doing is adding these two rows together to get a 0 in this position, but in order to add the two rows together to get a 0 here, we want the elements in this column to be opposites. So because this is positive 4, we want this to be negative 4, so our first step is to replace row 1 with negative 2 times row 1. That would give us negative 4, positive 2, and negative 8. Second row stays the same for right now. Now we're going to get a 0 here by replacing row 2 with row 1 plus row 2. The first row will stay the same. Now the second row, we're going to add row 1 and row 2. Negative 4 plus 4 is 0. Well, 2 plus negative 2 is also 0. And then negative 8 plus 5 is negative 3. Now that we have the 0 in the correct position, let's take a look at our main diagonal, which should be here. Remember, the first entry in every row must be 1. So to make this a 1, we're going to replace row 1 with negative 1/4 times row 1. Looking at the second row, we have a 0 in the main diagonal, which indicates we'll have either no solution or infinite solutions, which we'll come back to, but we still want this first entry here to be positive 1, so we're going to replace row 2 with negative 1/3 times row 2. So we have negative 1/4 times negative 4, that's positive 1. Negative 1/4 times 2, that's negative 2/4, or negative 1/2. And negative 1/4 times negative 8 is positive 2. For row 2, we would have 0, 0, and then negative 1/3 times negative 3 is positive 1. Now we're going to go ahead and write this back as a system of equations. So looking at this first row, this is telling us that 1x minus 1/2 y equals 2, or just x minus 1/2 y equals 2. But now looking at the second row, this is telling us that 0x plus 0y equals 1, or just 0 equals 1. So when we have an equation that doesn't contain variables, it's either going to be always true or always false. What we know is 0 does not equal 1, therefore this is false, meaning our system has no solution. So notice how in this case, we had a 0 in the main diagonal, and because of this 1 here, the result was we had no solution, which means our system is an inconsistent system. Now if we want to verify this, we could graph the two lines to make sure these two lines don't intersect. So let's go ahead and do that. Here are the graph of the two linear equations. Notice how the lines are parallel, which means they never intersect, verifying that our system has no solution. I hope you found this explanation helpful.